Hey, it's Playhouse in the Morning, 194, 633 in the morning, 0, Amy Kay in the 194 Morning Playhouse. So we talked a little bit about this guy yesterday, but he had kind of an interesting tactic as he was trying to get out of a speeding ticket that he knew was coming his way.
Yeah, there was no reason for that at all.
I would put people's
lives into safety.
I just found out that Putin has just said he's going to launch nuclear thermal war against the world. And I was trying to get back to my house, finally, what's going on?
I mean, I heard all these crazy stories about Vladimir Putin. I thought I got to speed on home. Now, the guy still got the speeding ticket. It didn't work out for him, but it does beg the question, what excuse did you use to get out of a speeding ticket? And better yet, ones that actually worked. You successfully managed to talk your way out of it. And when I say excuse, I mean, you probably didn't really need to be speeding, but you gave this explanation and the guy went, hey, there you go, I'm going to let you go. Have you ever get out of a speeding ticket before, Amy?
I think it's seriously the only time I've been pulled over when I moved here. I was driving and coming back from Minneapolis, and this is a real story, so it's not an excuse, and that's why I told the cops. There were semi-trucks. So I was trying to speed to get around and get in front of them.
Okay. A lot of people don't like to be kind of next to those. Sure.
And I told him that and he said, okay, I got a warning. Not completely out of it. I got a warning. And he said, just don't speed next time.
Now, when you say warning, did he actually like write something down?
Yes, he did. Okay. I got like a written warning.
Okay. So it wasn't just like a verbal like wave of the finger.
This is my warning. No, I got like a written warning.
Okay, so that's a little bit more serious.
Yeah.
But you did end up paying any money.
No, I didn't pay any money, and that's the only thing I've got.
I have one of those faces that says, doesn't matter what he says, I want to give him a ticket. So I think any time I've ever been pulled over, I've probably been given a ticket.
For anything?
Yeah. You know how some people have those faces where you're just like, no, not today there, buddy. That's my face. I got a not today there, buddy face.
One time, I had a headlight out, and I got pulled over for that, and I started crying, and I said, I don't know how to change a headlight.
And that worked on you, too?
Yeah.
See, again, things that'll work probably better for you than me, just like bawling. Like, if I start bawling, they'd be like, what is going on here? You start crying, they're like, oh, poor Amy.
But I really don't know how to change a headlight. I didn't even know. I said I didn't know it was out, and now I said, I don't know what to do. Where do I go? What do I have to do?
And did he give you some advice while you were crying and bawling about the headlight?
Like, honestly, we should think about if this woman should even have a license. Does she have a brain?
So how long did it take you to get that covered then?
I went and got it right away. I was freaked out.
Did you get a written warning for that too? Or was he just like, get out of here crying,
lady?
He
was like, get out of here and go get it fixed.
Because he said he had the one.
Yeah, one headlight.
One headlight. And that's a song about one headlight.
But this is like when I first started driving, so I really had no clue what to do.
I think it's a shame if you are driving around and you know you only have one headlight, it's a shame if you don't have this song just queued up ready to go. Because how fun would that have been for him to walk up and while you're crying and he wants to talk to you about this headlight being out, if this had been the song that you had playing in the car, I feel like he'd appreciated it.
George, you think he'd be like kind of annoyed, like you think this is a joke?
Yeah, it was a complete coincidence. I just love this song. I have no idea why this is on right now. Actually, a lot of a musical interruption there just to hear him say one headlight 40 seconds later. You ever get yourself out of a speeding ticket? You talked your way out of it. You had an excuse and it ended up not being a ticket for you. What are you seeing for text there, Amy Kay?
Someone said, I had just picked up dinner and as I got pulled over, I told him I didn't want the food to get cold for my wife or my kids. They would be upset. And he gave me a look like he had been in that situation before and let me go. Someone else said my speedometer was not working and he believed it. I didn't get a ticket.
You think he'd be like, you should probably get that looked at. You need that.
Yeah, you do need it.
I do like the poor guy that was like, I've been there before, came home with cold food.
No way, yeah.
Better get there. You don't want to be microwaving that pizza. And wouldn't you have a situation like that where probably should have got a ticket, but you talked your way on out of it? 237, it's Text Playhouse 35270. Lauv's on. To be young and in love in New York City. It's Playhouse, Y94. Time by that time you got out of a ticket. Probably a speeding ticket, get pulled over, and by all means, you probably should have got a ticket, but whatever thing you said, you didn't get a ticket. What are we seeing, ABK?
Somebody said, one time I was the DD. I got pulled over because I was speeding. However, I had a bunch of drunk friends in the back of my car, and they were getting ready to throw up. And I told the police officer that, and he said, thanks for being the responsible one tonight, and he let me go. Someone else said, my father was a police officer, and he said that there was a car that was speeding towards him over a road with a little bump on it in the middle, and he swears it caught air. So anyways, when he got to the vehicle and stopped it, the driver said, you must want to see my pilot license because I was flying. And he said he laughed and he couldn't give her a ticket due to that one-liner.
You know, if you just have a good joke queued up ready to go, there's probably something that doesn't get enough credit. You know, how many serious or annoying or rude people do they deal with every day? A good laugh probably gets you onto something.
I feel like that is a good one. Someone else said I was speeding, but another car just passed me. Then I got pulled over and I said, what about him? He was going faster than me. And the cop came up, and the cop said maybe it was him who came up on his radar, and he let me go.
Wow. See, now I feel like there's a little bit of luck in that one.
Yeah.
A little bit. And for you, that instance where you probably should got a ticket, but you ended up not getting the ticket.
Oh, I said I had to go to the bathroom.
You told them you had to go to the bathroom?
I did. That's why I was speeding.
You're in the Playhouse on Y94.
I want me back.
It's Playhouse Y94. You probably should got a speeding ticket, but for whatever reason, you ended up not getting the speeding ticket. What that excuse or rationale was, what are you getting there, Amy K?
Someone said I was bringing my 8-month pregnant girlfriend food, and he let me go. Someone else said, speeder here, I've been pulled over 8 times. And nice. I think the trick is to just be nice, be polite, and I have had 0 tickets. And someone else said, I once said that I was late for work.
And what was the instance where you had like an excuse or a reason that got you out of the ticket? Hello.
Yes, I have said that I didn't see the speed limit sign, or I've said that I'm from out of town, or I just start crying.
And it works?
The crying works the best because I find that it makes them really uncomfortable.
You know, I can see how that works. I feel like that usually will only work, though, if it's a male police officer and a female that get pulled over. Like, I don't know if I cry to a police officer, regardless of their gender, if they care that I'm crying, if I'm being honest.
It's not like you crying because you want to get out of the ticket. I think you're just, like, nervous and you don't know what to do. You're overwhelmed and you cry.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
But still, it's not going to work for me. People just be weird. They probably think I was like either drunk
on
drugs if I started bawling.
They'd probably be like, is there anything else going on with you, sir? Are you sure you're okay?
What else has happened? What other piece of the story are we missing? You got out of the speeding ticket. Any final ones?
Someone else said, I used the excuse that I was just going with the flow of traffic. And someone else said, I was late to pick up my child, which was true, and I did get out of the ticket.
Well, and that's one of those things. He probably honestly felt bad for pulling you over.
Yeah, taking up more time.
Like, sure, yeah, get to your kid. Well, Playhouse family member Jenna's wondering if she's totally crazy for something she suggested to her boyfriend, because he's really not all about it, but it's something she wanted to do. What that is after Måneskin.
Put your love.